Even though you and I are both conscious about our health, I'm sure we have both had to consider what to do regarding alcohol consumption. With numerous studies on alcohol and its effects on health, it can be challenging to determine whether an occasional glass of wine is beneficial or harmful. I have faced this dilemma myself, and after reading extensive research, I have come to a conclusion. In this video, we will present you with all the necessary information about alcohol and explain to you how it impacts several areas of your health and lifespan so that you can make an informed decision too, whatever it might be. I am Linda Granfors.
And I am Alessandro Carpentiero. We at Beyond Sapiens help you optimize your health and longevity.
When we think about alcohol, we often picture drinks like beer or wine. But what exactly is the alcohol in these beverages? It's a specific type called ethanol, typically produced through the fermentation of sugars using yeast or other microorganisms. It's crucial, however, to comprehend its impact on our health and how it can affect our longevity. While the occasional glass of wine or beer may appear harmless, it's vital to acknowledge the potential harm that alcohol can pose. One of the most significant concerns is its association with chronic diseases, which can significantly shorten one's life. Chronic alcohol abuse can lead to conditions such as liver cirrhosis, as ethanol is primarily metabolized by the liver. This condition involves the replacement of healthy liver tissue with scar tissue, often resulting in life-threatening complications. Alcohol's influence on heart disease is equally complex. Although some studies suggest that moderate alcohol consumption may have cardiovascular benefits, excessive drinking can lead to high blood pressure, cardiomyopathy, and irregular heart rhythms. So it's worth considering why you should consume alcohol for a potential small benefit when there is a risk that this benefit could turn into a negative effect, especially considering that there are several other holistic options for better heart health, like exercise and a balanced diet. Another alarming point is that alcohol is classified as a Group 1 carcinogen by the World Health Organization for a good reason. Long-term alcohol use is associated with various cancers that can be fatal to your lifespan and overall health. Alcohol can also weaken your immune system, making you more susceptible to infections with serious consequences as you age. But alcohol's negative impact extends beyond the physical realm. Mental health concerns are significant, and the most alarming factor is the risk of addiction. Alcohol can create a cycle of dependence, withdrawal, and relapse, placing constant stress on your body and diminishing your overall resilience and longevity while strongly affecting the people around you. So, while moderate alcohol consumption may not carry immediate health risks and has been shown to potentially offer some cardiovascular benefits, it's crucial to be aware of the various risks associated with it. Recognize that the line between moderation and excess is blurry. We're all uniquely sensitive to alcohol. Personally, I have chosen not to risk my health by consuming even an occasional glass of alcohol, as I do not see any benefit in it for myself. If you decide to consume alcohol, it is crucial to do so in moderation and just occasionally. And if you feel like you struggle controlling its use, it might be worth talking to a professional. Remember that your choices today can shape your lifespan, overall health, and the well-being and happiness of those around you.
Alcohol use is strongly associated with social events, such as dinners, parties, or post-dinner gatherings. While it might facilitate spending quality time with others, it can reduce your sleep quality by almost 40%. But how is that? After all, you might actually fall asleep easier than usual when you have one or two drinks in the evening. That is true, and it's thanks to alcohol's sedative properties. But it doesn't translate to increasing sleep quality or quantity, which is actually what we're looking for. Sleep is one of the cornerstones for your health and longevity, and focusing on improving it and protecting it should always be one of your very top priorities, which is why sleep is one of the four pillars of our longevity coaching program. So let's take a closer look at how alcohol affects your sleep. When you drink alcohol, it is absorbed into your bloodstream from your stomach and small intestine. Your liver eventually metabolizes the alcohol, but this is a slow process, so excess alcohol will remain in your system for quite some time. To understand how alcohol affects sleep, it is helpful to know about the different sleep stages. A sleep cycle lasts usually between 80 and 100 minutes, consisting of four stages that cycle throughout the night. Non-REM 1 is the lightest, during which your muscles relax and your heart rate and breathing slow down. Non-REM 2 is the stage during which most brain activity decreases. Non-REM 3, known as deep sleep, is the deepest stage, during which your body repairs itself. Last but not least, we have the REM stage, which is important for mood, memories, and learning. One of the biggest problems with drinking alcohol in the evening is that it can interfere with your body's ability to transition between different sleep stages. Specifically, it can increase the suppression of REM sleep during the first two sleep cycles. So even if you fall asleep faster, alcohol can lead to poor sleep quality. That is also because alcohol is known to suppress melatonin production, and an interesting study, which you will find in the description, shows a suppression of 15% around 2 hours after drinking and 19% around 3 hours after drinking. And given how important melatonin is to fall asleep and stay asleep, you can see why alcohol and sleep don't really go hand in hand. On top of that, alcohol can influence the functioning of certain muscles surrounding the airways, potentially affecting your breathing during sleep and worsening sleep problems, such as snoring and sleep apnea. In addition, alcohol can cause dehydration, which can further disrupt sleep. If you have a sleep tracker, you will clearly see how alcohol strongly affects your sleep. For example, you will notice that your resting heart rate is elevated and that your HRV is much lower than your baseline, as alcohol suppresses parasympathetic nerve activity and leads to increased sympathetic nerve activity. In simple terms, it puts your body more into a fight or flight and less in rest and digest. Moreover, if you drink alcohol regularly, the effects on sleep will be more severe, and this can lead to several problems, including daytime fatigue, difficulty concentrating, and mood swings. It can also increase your risk of chronic health conditions like heart disease, stroke, and diabetes. So while occasional alcohol consumption in the evening is deeply ingrained in many cultures, a deeper understanding of its relationship to sleep can help you make a more informed decision. That doesn't mean you should give up alcohol altogether, but if you want to reduce its negative effects on sleep, you should not have any alcohol at least 4 hours prior bedtime. Of course, it's important to note that alcohol influences your health way beyond sleep. That's why I personally decided to give it up completely more than 3 years ago, and that just works for me. At that time, I indulged in one or two occasional drinks per week, such as beer or a glass of wine. But as I was already living the healthiest life possible, I found myself on several occasions not finishing the drink that I had ordered, something that never happened in the past. So I trusted my body's signaling and naturally stopped alcohol. Often, our body already knows what's best for us, and all we have to do is listen.
100%. Listening to your body is the best thing you can do. Something we haven't discussed yet is how alcohol really impacts your brain. Alcohol profoundly impacts your brain, and understanding these effects is crucial for your longevity and overall health. When you ingest alcohol, it quickly finds its way to your brain through your bloodstream, disrupting the balance of neurotransmitters. This disruption leads to a temporarily calming effect, which can be responsible for the feelings of relaxation and sociability often associated with moderate alcohol consumption. However, this same effect impairs your cognitive functions, such as memory and decision-making, especially when your alcohol intake exceeds moderation. If your consumption becomes chronic and excessive, it can result in structural changes within your brain. Specifically, it can shrink brain tissue, particularly in areas that govern impulse control and memory. Over time, this neurotoxicity can damage your nerve cells and their connections, manifesting as impaired motor skills, coordination, and mood regulation. One important aspect is that your brain's response to alcohol is not static. It adapts to frequent alcohol consumption by developing tolerance, necessitating higher alcohol intake to achieve the same effects. This is extremely dangerous, as you may move from moderate drinking to more excessive as you don't feel the effects as strongly. This phenomenon can also lead to physical and psychological dependencies and start building addiction. Moreover, alcohol has a notable impact on your mood. While it often induces a sense of sociability in social settings, excessive consumption can trigger mood swings, depression, and an increased susceptibility to mental health disorders. This complex interplay between mood enhancement and cognitive impairment is a critical factor to consider when evaluating the potential social benefits of alcohol. However, concerns extend beyond immediate cognitive effects. Chronic alcohol use is linked to an increased risk of neurodegenerative conditions, such as Alzheimer's disease. Interestingly, some studies suggest that moderate alcohol consumption may reduce this risk. Still, this potential benefit must be weighed carefully against the risks, especially as the line between moderation and excess is impossible to recognize. So consider, would you like to play with a double-edged knife if you can focus on a holistically healthy life to ensure your chances of avoiding neurodegenerative risks? So really ask yourself, is it worth consuming something that changes your brain chemistry and your being while impacting your health for the sake of a social and calming feeling? For me, it is not worth it. And I highly encourage you to test how you would feel by drinking a non-alcoholic beverage instead and enjoying the moment as your full present self. You might be surprised how much more you can enjoy life while sober.
Alcohol impacts several processes in our organism, including blood sugar levels and metabolism. We will delve into blood sugar levels and their relation to longevity in a future video. So if you haven't already, please consider subscribing to our channel. To bring you quickly up to speed, blood sugar levels refer to the glucose concentration in your bloodstream. Glucose is the primary energy source for your cells, and your body carefully regulates these levels to ensure your cells receive enough energy to function properly. This delicate interplay involves insulin, a hormone that acts like a key that opens the door to your cells, allowing glucose to enter. Maintaining healthy blood sugar levels is essential for longevity, as it may help prevent chronic health conditions and slow down the aging process. So to understand the immediate impact of alcohol on glucose, it is important to know the role of the liver in glucose metabolism. When alcohol is consumed, it is metabolized primarily in the liver. This process inhibits the liver's ability to produce glucose. However, alcohol also stimulates the breakdown of stored glycogen into glucose. The result of these opposing actions is a relatively balanced glucose response in most people. This is apparently a good thing, but when considering topics surrounding our health, we should never adopt a single-sided approach, as that will prevent us from looking at the bigger, most important pictures. In fact, by balancing your glucose response with alcohol at dinner, you might end up disrupting your sleep, leading to a greater glycemic response to breakfast the following morning. A good alternative that doesn't come with adverse effects is to add some vinegars to a carbohydrate-rich meal. That has been shown to have glucose-lowering effects and won't disrupt, among many other things, your sleep as alcohol does. Besides glucose and blood sugar levels, something worth mentioning is the calorie density of alcohol. When it comes to longevity, it's crucial to keep a steady weight with healthy levels of lean mass and body fat. And additional calories coming in liquid form might prevent you from reaching that goal. the amount of calories a drink contains varies. For example, a serving of red wine can be almost 150 calories. Of course, you could make up for it by eating less, but I would much rather take those 150 calories from real, nutrient-dense foods like legumes, whole grains, nuts, seeds, avocados, and olive oil. But that is just what works for me. Ultimately, optimizing for longevity doesn't mean living a life of deprivation, but on the contrary, it means making science-based decisions that align with your values and goals, with the ultimate goal of living a truly fulfilling life.
We hope this video has provided you with a comprehensive understanding of the effects of alcohol on your health, allowing you to make informed decisions about how to consume it. If you are on the journey of improving your well-being and lifespan, we would love to work with you. We provide an all-in-one solution for health and longevity through our 3-month longevity coaching program. It is a one-on-one coaching program where you get a comprehensive, fully personalized coaching plan that includes your nutrition, exercise, sleep, and mindset. Our goal is to create lifelong change in your life as sustainably and holistically as possible to help you gain many healthy years into your lifespan. If you are health conscious and willing to prioritize your longevity, you are the one we're looking for. If this is you, please click the link in the description to learn more about this program or book a free exploration call with Alessandro and me. We would love to meet you.
And if you want to gain new knowledge and awareness to optimize your health and longevity, please subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss our science-based content. Thanks for watching, and we will see you in the next video.